will solve a problem on cleans construction. Previously we discussed about cleans construction procedure and the formulae, whatever we have to use for the problems. Based on that we will be solving problems on cleans construction today. This comes under the second module, that is velocity and acceleration analysis by graphical method. So this is the problem, problem number one. The crank and connecting rod of a reciprocating engine are 200 mm and 700 mm respectively. The crank is rotating in the clockwise direction at 120 radians per second. Find with the help of Cleans construction velocity, first one, velocity and acceleration of piston. Second one, velocity and acceleration of midpoint of the connecting rod. Okay, and third one, angular velocity and angular acceleration of the connecting rod at the instant when the crank is at 30 degree to the inner dead center, IDC. Okay, so there are two dead centers for the crank, two positions. One is called inner dead center and the other one is called outer dead center. That is when the piston is at the two extremes, we will be getting the inner dead center and outer dead center. That is when piston comes near to the crank, near to the crank end, then it will be one particular dead center, that is outer dead center. And if it is in the other extreme, then it is the inner dead center that we will discuss. The crank and connecting rod of the reciprocating engine are 200 and 700 mm respectively. So that means the crank length is 200 mm and reciprocating and the connecting rod length is 700 mm here. Okay, so the crank is rotating in the clockwise direction at 120 radians per second. So that means it is the angular velocity of the crank they have given. Next, here they have also given the crank angle from IDC. Okay, so first one we have to find velocity and acceleration of the piston. In the second position, second part, we have to find velocity and acceleration of the midpoint of the connecting rod. And in the third one, we have to find velocity and angular acceleration of the connecting rod. Okay, so we will try to solve the problem. Okay, so whatever is the given data, we will write down first. So they have given the slider crank mechanism, that is reciprocating engine mechanism. So you know that in engine the mechanism is slider crank mechanism. So here you have a crank length, that is OA, they have given as 200 millimeter. So this is the crank, OA is the crank, that is 200 millimeter, and connecting rod length AB is 700 millimeter. So AB is the connecting rod, so this is the connecting rod, so the length of the connecting rod is 700 millimeter. So AB length is 700 millimeter, and the angular velocity of the crank, the crank is rotating with the angular velocity, that is they have given as 120 radian per second. So next, they have given angle turned by the crank from IDC, that is inner dead center, they have given. So from here, okay, so this is when the crank is rotating like this. So this portion is the inner dead center, IDC. And this particular position, it becomes the ODC, outer dead center. So we have to take the angle 30 degree with reference to the horizontal, that is this particular angle theta, we have to take it as 30 degree. So here the crank length they have given as 200 millimeter. So this we cannot directly take it on the graph sheet, because 200 millimeter is 20 centimeter. So it is too large to take on the graph sheet. So what we will do is we'll try to scale it down to a smaller dimensions. Then we can write write it on the graph sheet, and then we can convert it back from the scale dimension to the original dimensions. Okay, so next step is, what we'll do is we'll consider the scale factor. Okay, scaling we'll do it. So here you can take a convenient scale factor. So for 200 mm dimensions, I have taken 50 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter on the graph sheet. So that means, so 50 mm dimensions of the link will be taken as 1 centimeter on the graph sheet. The scale factor is, so here scale factor is 50. So if you consider the link crank OA, they have given in the problem as 200 mm dimension. So if you scale it down, so for example 50 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter, then 200 mm becomes how much? 200 divided by 50, so it becomes 4 centimeter. Similarly, the connecting rod AB, they have given as 700 millimeter. So this, if you scale it down, 700 divided by 50, so how much it will become? So it will become this much dimensions, okay, 14 centimeter. So crank length, how much you should be taking on the graph sheet? So you should be taking crank length OA is equal to 4 centimeter, and connecting rod length AB, so you should be taking 14 centimeter on the graph sheet. So we will construct according to the scale dimensions in the graph sheet. So first step here is, we'll construct the velocity triangle first, Kleene's velocity diagram, and then we'll do the acceleration part. So now what we'll do is, so we'll construct the crank length by taking OA is equal to 4 centimeter, and from at an angle of 30 degree, and from here AB will take 14 centimeter, and we will cut the arc on the horizontal line which is drawn from this point O. So OB, you write a horizontal line from OA, okay, from there we take an angle of 30 degree from this side, from the left side, and then we will draw the 4 centimeter line, and we will cut the 30 degree line, and that point we will mark it as A. Okay, from there we will take 14 centimeter and we will cut the arc on the horizontal line, so we get the point as B. So OAB we will construct, and later on what we will do is, this AB part, the connecting rod, that we will extend the line, and from here, from the fixed link, we will draw a vertical line, so wherever it intersects, okay, so that point is C. This is how we will write the velocity triangle. First what we will do, we will draw a vertical line, okay, which is perpendicular to the horizontal line, and that line is called OC, and AB, whatever you are extending, so that becomes AC. Okay, so this lengths we have to measure, OC and AC. So if you measure from the graph sheet, you will be getting OC is equal to approximately 2.54 centimeter and AC is equal to 3.46 centimeter approximately. So you will take approximate value, whatever you have got, you write that value here. Okay, this I have taken accurate value, but in your case, whatever the measurement you have got, you write it here. Okay, so this is the construction of the Kleene's velocity diagram. So after writing this, we have to measure the value, and we have to write the dimensions in centimeter only. Whatever the dimensions we have taken in the graph sheet, the same dimensions you have to write here. So first we will calculate the velocity of the piston. Okay, so we know that the formula is VBO is equal to omega OA into OC. Okay, so this we have to multiply here by scale factor in the problem. So how much ever scale we have considered, that scale we have to multiply. So VBO is equal to omega OA, that is angular velocity of the crank, multiplied by length OC. So this OC we have measured in the previous slide. So here OC is how much? OC is 2.54 centimeter. So omega they have given in the problem as 120 radian per second. So this you substitute as it is, multiplied by length 2.54 centimeter, you keep it as it is, multiplied by scale factor. The scale factor we have considered is how much? Scale factor is 50. So we'll multiply this by 50. So we get the velocity of the piston is equal to 15240 millimeter per second. So we'll get the answer in millimeter because we have considered in terms of millimeter. So we'll get 15240 millimeter per second. That you can convert it to meter per second. So you will get 115.24. So three decimals if you shift, you get 15.24 meter per second. So the velocity of the piston here is 15.24 meter per second. Next we will calculate the acceleration of the piston. So for that we have to write the acceleration diagram. So with A as the center point, okay, so with A as the center point, we will take the length AC, okay, this AC, and we will draw one circle, and with the AC as the radius we draw one circle, and with the midpoint of the connecting rod, that is AB, that point you mark it as K, okay, so with that center point and AB as the diameter, okay, so AB as a diameter, we draw one more circle, okay, so these two circles intersect at point D and E, okay, so D and E, if you join the line, that line will cut the connecting rod at the point H, and it will cut the horizontal at the point F, okay, so here the quadrilateral whatever we have shaded, that is OAHF is the acceleration diagram. OAHF is the acceleration diagram. So here what we have to do is we have to measure, okay, so we have to measure here the dimensions of HF and FO. So this dimension we have to measure, HF, this length, and this length F to O, this dimension we have to measure, okay, so HF if you measure you will get it as 1.86 centimeter, and FO from here to here if you measure you will get 4 centimeter, okay. So the acceleration of the piston formula they have given as FBO is equal to omega square AO into FO, that multiply you have to multiply it by scale factor. So FBO is equal to omega AO is 120 radian per second, that you square it, 120 square multiplied by length FO. So previously we have measured FO is equal to 4 centimeter. So that you take here multiplied by scale factor, that is 50. So you get 288 followed by 4 zeros millimeter per second square. So this if you convert it to meter per second square, so 3 decimals you have to shift, you get 2880 meter per second square. So this is the acceleration of the piston. So we have calculated the first part, that is velocity and acceleration of the piston we have calculated. Next we have to calculate velocity and acceleration of the midpoint of the connecting rod. Okay, velocity at the midpoint of the connecting rod, that is K. So this part we have to find. So for that what we have to do is, so we have written anyhow the velocity diagram, AOC. So we find out the midpoint of AC, so that point you mark it as L. So from the fixed point O, you draw one line joining OL. So you measure this distance OL. So if you measure the distance you get 2.8 centimeter. So in order to calculate velocity at the midpoint of connecting rod, what we have to do, so AC midpoint you mark it as L, from that midpoint L you join straight line to O and you measure this distance, so you will get it as
2.8 centimeter. So next we will calculate the velocity at the midpoint of the connecting rod. So velocity at the midpoint we write it as velocity of K with reference to VKO, that is equal to omega AO into LO multiplied by scale factor. So scale factor we have taken 50. So omega AO is angular velocity, they have given 120 radian per second, multiplied by this particular length OL or LO. So that is 2.8 into 50. So this, if you calculate, you will get 16800 millimeter per second. So you shift 3 decimals, you get 16.8 meter per second. So the velocity at the midpoint of the connecting rod is 16.8 meter per second. We have to find out what is the acceleration at the midpoint of the connecting rod also. So for that we have to write the acceleration diagram.
So in order to find the acceleration at the midpoint of the connecting rod, so that is K is the midpoint of the connecting rod AB. In order to find out acceleration here, what we have to do is we have to draw a parallel line, that is a horizontal line parallel to the horizontal line. We have to draw a line, that is, this is the line of stroke parallel to this. We have to write one line, so which will be joining the line AF. Okay, so first what we do is from A to F we join one line, and from the point K we draw a horizontal line. So wherever it intersects, that point you mark it as J. Okay, and you join J to O. Okay, so you join this J to O distance. So I will repeat once again the procedure how to find the acceleration at the midpoint of the connecting rod, that is K. So first step here is join A to F, a straight line. So from point A, that is the OA crank, okay, so you join A to F a straight line, and from midpoint K you draw a horizontal line. So wherever the lines intersect, that point you mark it as J, and from the point J you join a straight line to fixed point O. So you measure this particular distance, that is JO. So JO, if you measure, you get it as 3.86 centimeter. Okay, 3.86 centimeter on your graph sheet. So next what we'll do is we'll use the acceleration at the midpoint of the connecting rod is given by formula FKO is equal to omega square AO into JO, that you have to multiply it by scale factor. So acceleration is given by that is omega square AO is the angular velocity of the crank, so 120 square multiplied by JO. JO we have measured previously, so JO is 3.86 centimeter, that you substitute here, multiplied by scale factor. Scale factor is 50. So if you calculate, you will get this value, okay, 2779200 millimeter per second square. 3 decimals you shift, you get 2779.2 meter per second square. So this is the acceleration at the midpoint of the connecting rod. So second part we have calculated, that is velocity and acceleration of the midpoint of the connecting rod. Next, lastly, we have to calculate what is the angular velocity and angular acceleration of the connecting rod. We have to find out. So here we will find the angular velocity of the connecting rod. So the angular velocity of the connecting rod is omega PA. So omega BA is given by formula, omega BA is equal to VBA divided by BA. What is VBA? VBA is the linear velocity of the connecting rod divided by length of the connecting rod will give you the angular velocity. So first we will find what is the linear velocity of the connecting rod. So linear velocity of the connecting rod is given by this formula. What is that? VBA is equal to omega OA into AC into scale. Okay, so VBA is the linear velocity of the connecting rod. First we will find. So omega OA is the angular velocity of the crank that you know 120 radian per second given in the problem. So AC, we have already found from the velocity diagram. So if you go back to that particular slide where we have written the Kleene's velocity diagram. So AC we have measured it as 3.46 centimeter. So that we will substitute in the formula here, and we will calculate what is VBA. So VBA is equal to 120 into 3.46 centimeter into scale. So scale is given as 50. So that if you multiply, VBA is equal to 120 into 3.46 into 50, you will get this number. So 20760 millimeter per second. So we have kept it in millimeter per second only. Why? Because the length of the connecting rod is also 700, which is in millimeter. So millimeter if you divide, okay, so it get cancelled and you get in radian per second. So that is why we have kept in millimeter only. And the length of the connecting rod is 700 millimeter. You divide this, you get angular velocity of the connecting rod omega BA is equal to 29.66 radian per second. Similarly, we will find out angular acceleration of the connecting rod. So angular acceleration of the connecting rod is alpha BA. So alpha BA is equal to FBA divided by BA. FBA is the linear acceleration of the connecting rod divided by length of the connecting rod. So linear acceleration we'll find out first. So linear acceleration is given by formula omega square AO into HF into scale. So omega square is the angular velocity of the crank, that is 120 square multiplied by HF. So HF value we have already found from the acceleration diagram. So if you go back to the acceleration diagram, so we will see there, okay, so HF value is 1.86 centimeter. So here we can see that HF value is 1.86 centimeter. That value you substitute in the formula multiplied by scale, so you get some number. So that will be 1339200 millimeter per second square. So this is the linear acceleration. Okay, so units will be millimeter per second square. So that divided by length of the connecting rod, that is 700 mm. So you will get alpha BA as 1913.14 radian per second square. So this is the angular acceleration of the connecting rod. So in the third part of the question, we have found out what is the angular velocity of the connecting rod and angular acceleration of the connecting rod.